Hey guys, thank you for checking out our video today. My name's Sean Elders. I'm the founder of Pinnacle Combat Arts. Like, subscribe, comment down below, hit the bell so you can be notified every time we get a new video. Today, we're gonna be talking about martial arts. Which one is right for me? Let's get started. When we talk about the martial arts, there's so many things to choose from. You have so many options to choose from. It wasn't like that back when I was growing up. There are four things that you need to look at first when you're thinking about starting martial arts. The first thing is that why is it that you have decided that you want to do martial arts? What inspired you to make that choice, to make that decision? That's the first thing I would say. What was the thing that inspired you? Was it a movie? Was it a martial art fight? Did you go and see a competition, or did you go see, you know, what was it that you saw? What was the thing that brought you to your attention? I put it into four different categories. The first category is culture, philosophy, okay? Maybe the culture and the philosophy of it. For instance, when I was growing up in the 1980s and I started martial arts, the culture and the philosophy was Asian, either Japanese, Chinese, Korean, Vietnamese, you know, there's so many different things, Thai, Filipino, Indonesian, there's so many different martial arts, and then you also have the European martial arts. But when I was growing up, the Asian martial arts was huge. Bruce Lee was huge. And so one thing that could draw you in, that may have drawn you in, is the culture and philosophy of one of these arts. So that's number one. Number two would be competition. You want to earn trophies and go out and compete and better yourself over time. That's part of what martial arts is all about, is bettering yourself, and getting better over time. So competition, achieving belts, you know, earning rank, going out, receiving medals, things like that. That may be a reason why you would want to do martial arts. Number three would be fitness. Fitness is a big, huge thing. Either you want to lose weight or you want to stay in shape. Finally, the fourth one could be self-protection. A lot of people call it self-defense. Self-protection is the key. You know, maybe you were in a situation and you got mugged, or maybe you had a family member that got mugged, or something happened. Maybe you saw violence. Maybe you were in a situation where you felt like you were unprepared and you felt vulnerable. So those are the four basic things that I break it down to. That's the first step, is to really understand why you want to learn martial arts. What inspired you? Why do I say that's the most important? The reason why it's most important is because that draws out the passion. That's what inspires you. That's what creates the passion of it. Passion and inspiration is what helps drive you long-term when it comes to the martial arts. If you're doing it just for that, you get an instant gratification, you lose interest really quick. But if you have this long state thing that keeps you going, whatever that thing is that keeps you going, and you keep your eye on that thing, that's what's gonna help you to keep going, okay? So passion and being inspired is very important. The second part is, where do you live? What is your location? Where do you live? If you live in a little city, a little town of 800 people or 8,000 people, your options for martial arts may be very, very limited. Who knows? So I would say to you, when it comes down to martial arts, go to the closest martial arts school you can. Try it out and see how you like it. A lot of people worry about, you know, this style or that style. But the thing is that you have to go in and you have to immerse yourself and start to educate and get an idea and a feeling of, you know, what it is that you like and what it is you don't like. Just because you see something at first and somebody tells you something doesn't mean that that's what you're going to end up liking. It's all about you having fun, learning something, and making it enjoyable. Maybe meeting new people and growing as a human being. That's what martial arts is all about for me. For me, martial arts is about developing the mind, body, spirit as one. That is a key element to the martial arts. If it is that you're interested in culture and philosophy, traditional martial arts is that's what you're going to want to go to a lot of times, because those traditional martial arts talk about discipline, meditation, you know, different things like that, depending on who your teacher is, obviously. But traditional martial arts is a great avenue when you really enjoy the Japanese or Chinese culture, enjoying the philosophy, the parables, whatever the case may be. Going into one of those things would be the way to go. Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu or kickboxing or Muay Thai or, you know, boxing or, you know, those different types of athlete, Taekwondo. Those are the different types of things that where you would go in. You, first of all, you're trying to achieve a higher ranking belt and you're competing, okay? My personal opinion about that varies based on whatever martial art that is. Every martial art has what I find attractive and what I don't. But I'm not trying to tell you or tell you what is good and what is bad, because that is based on your opinion. Okay? When it comes to reality-based, when it comes to I know what works in a combat situation. Now that's a different topic. Okay? So when we talk about fitness, I always say fitness kickboxing or conditioning kickboxing, that's one of the best ways to go. Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is a great way to work out, is because you're on the ground, you're using every muscle in your body. So all those things play a very important role when it comes to our fitness aspect. It all depends on how far you want to go into that. A class, a kickboxing or kickboxing conditioning class, vary based on that. Do you want to make high impact? Do you want to train with a partner, or do you only want to train on a bag, for instance? You know, there, all those things play a very important role in what is it that you want. Do you want to, you know, square up with somebody and they swing at you and you swing at them with or without protection on your head, headgear and stuff like that? That is all based on your personal, what you want out of this. Self-protection is the last one. So when it comes to self-protection, you need to understand that it has to do with somebody coming at you with a knife, you know, somebody, multiple attackers, single attacker, all those things play a role, you know. So there are different martial arts that you have to think about that are more likely to help you than others, okay? So your basic types of combatives would be boxing as you're striking or kickboxing, okay? And then jiu-jitsu. Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Those are the two I would say that are the basic of your foundation of your empty hand. But when we talk about weapons and even empty hand, Filipino Kali is a great one. Some of the Silat systems, they can be good depending on who your teacher is. A lot of this has to do with your teacher. How does your teacher teach? Do they pressure test, battle test, spar? Do they have a special program where they're actually putting on headgear and they're going at it 50, 60, 70, 80%? Are they having battle games? You know, those things are very important. So I also spoke about that. When it comes to if you want to do something more heavy contact, Muay Thai, Junfan Jeet Kune Do, kickboxing and boxing, okay? Those are things that you could focus on, okay? When it comes to like more traditional or closer to traditional styles, Kyokushin Kai is a very tough style that I studied in the past as well, that could help you with the hard kicking, the hard punching, those kind of things could be another one that you could do. That's more of a, it has some traditional elements to it, wearing a uniform and, you know, some of the cultural aspects, but you also have some tough, strong, hard hitting, you know, there's some really definitely some high impact. The Kyokushin Kai is a great one. If you're a big MMA fan, I always say, just because you're a big MMA fan and you want to get into MMA, sometimes you can go to an MMA school and it's good, okay? The coach is real good, but sometimes they're all over the place. And what I would say is, if you're wanting to get into MMA, I would say get a good boxing coach to start off with, or get a good wrestling coach or good jiu-jitsu coach. Start with one of those first to give you a foundation in one of those areas, whichever one interests you the most when it comes to MMA. Sometimes when you go to an MMA school, they have specific coaches that are dedicated to that one thing, what I would say is if you're going to a big, huge gym, go and say, I'm going to learn just one thing. You want to spend time doing just one thing for a period of time to get a good foundation in that before you just jump around. If you jump around, do all the classes, this is my personal opinion, then you're going to be all over the place. You're not going to have a good foundation in anything. You have to do high repetitions. So that's for MMA, somebody that's interested in MMA. The last thing I want to talk about is when it comes to an instructor. Ideally, you want to find an instructor. They have good credentials. They come from somebody that's good, or they have fighters. They have, if you're looking for something that's more competitive, that they have people that have been doing good in competition. You know, okay? If they have champions, that's a very important thing for you to focus on. If they don't have champions, they may not be good, but they may be great. The whole point is you got to go in there and check it out and see how it goes. My main thing that I would say is martial arts schools are designed to try to cater to every single person's needs, even when it doesn't really technically, they don't really suit those. So for instance, if you go to a Taekwondo school, okay, a Taekwondo school will tell you, I'm going to help you with your fitness, self-defense, you know, competition. And we may even have a class that's off to the side that's an MMA class. Come in and do it. I'm not trying to pick on Taekwondo, but this is the way that they market their schools now. The problem with that is that a lot of times those instructors, they're not necessarily always the best to learn from. So if you're a guy that wants to do MMA, but it's a Taekwondo school and they're going to try to convince you to join even when it's really not what you want. Okay. So be careful. Depends and across the board. I'm not going to just say that, you know, you could go into a place and they're just going to tell you whatever they need to tell you in some of these schools to just get you to join and sign, you know, sign a contract and all that. So understand that. So when you join a martial arts school, there's different types of martial arts schools that you can look at, okay? One could be a traditional dojo type school, okay? Where you go in and they market their school to provide everything for the whole family and all that stuff like that. Based on what kind of instructor is there will be based on what you want, okay? Then there's the gym type of atmosphere where it's like more of an MMA or boxing or that type of environment. That environment, sometimes there are good things about that environment, and sometimes there are negative things about a boxing gym, for instance, or an MMA gym. I always say, and I've had many, many students come in and train with me and say to me, they go, gosh, I went to that boxing gym, or gosh, I went to that MMA school, and I just felt lost. And the truth is that some boxing gyms, for instance, are focused on, you're going to go in, you pay a certain amount of money, and you hit the bag. There's not a lot of coaching going on, personal coaching going on, unless you're wanting to be a fighter, or you're going to be a punching bag to be a punching bag for a fighter that's getting ready. This is the truth about a lot of these boxing gyms. So know about, just understand that. I'm not saying all boxing gyms are like that, because they've been starting to change their ways, but a lot of boxing gyms, they're catered and they're focused on the fighter, because the fighter is what brings in the money. And the fighter, they're all about promoting, you know, their fighters. So unless you show a certain amount of initiative, they're not gonna really spend as much time with you as if you went to, for instance, if you went to a Jun Fan Jeet-Kune-Do school, they're gonna teach you boxing, hopefully, the proper way, and be able to spend time teaching you how to do things correctly. Instead of you're going to a boxing gym and they're just like, okay, hit the bag, you know, and they may show you one thing or whatever, but they don't really spend time, you know, and they don't have those kind of classes. The same thing in the MMA gym, it can be the same thing. So the gym atmosphere is another type of atmosphere you may love or you may not like it too much. Then you have, for instance, kind of the same thing as the dojo is the Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu school. A lot of Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu schools provide striking classes, you know, other classes besides just yoga, you know, all sorts of different types of things in the Jiu-Jitsu school. Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is great, you know, as long as you have a good teacher, and it all comes down to that. The only way to find out if you have a good teacher is not just by reading the reviews on Google, but by going in and getting and taking a couple classes and seeing how they treat their students, asking what is the relate, you know, how is everything going? It's important that you get a good instructor no matter what style you get into. Okay, so then the other kind of environment would be if you're in a small town, for instance, and they have a rec center. Sometimes, a lot of times, rec centers provide classes as well of teachers that just make sure that teacher has certification and it's legit. It's not some, you know, school, or it's not an instructor that just went to a weekend retreat. Find out about who their teacher is and how their teacher teaches their classes. Is it somebody that has to dedicate themselves to that martial art for a while, or are they just going in and getting, like, you know, there's a lot of Krav, I'm sorry, don't want to hate on the Krav Maga, but there's a lot of Krav Maga instructors out there that just went to a weekend class, and here they are, you know, they're teaching classes, you know, and they only took a weekend or a couple weekends. Guess what? It takes a good 10 years to become good at anything. You have to spend years learning and training. You can't just get some weekend certification and become an instructor. It's just not happening. So it's important that you understand who's your teacher, and who's your teacher's teacher, and how did your teacher get and receive their certifications? Did they earn it in a good way, or did they earn it over 1 year? This is a very important thing, okay? Nobody is a teacher after 1 year, I'm sorry. It's not gonna happen. You're not a good teacher after 1 year. It takes years to become a good instructor, okay? So that is a very important part of, and that's why, like, for instance, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, for the most part, they try to make sure that that student doesn't get a black belt until they're 8 to 10 years in, because they don't know enough. They need to learn, and they have to learn not only the techniques and learn how to be effective and be able to adapt in their own situation and become a good student to an advanced student, they also have to learn how to teach others, okay? And that's a very important part of being a good instructor. So always, always make sure that you do your research on where you're going, okay? And then the last one I always bring up, I like to bring this up too, because is the instructor that teaches out of their garage. If you can do research under that person and find out if they teach out of their, you know, just because somebody teaches out of their garage doesn't mean that they're not amazing instructors, because guess what? A lot of the instructors that I studied under were amazing. And guess what? We train in their backyard. We train in their garage. We train, you know, out in the park. There has been a lot of great instruction that I've received when it wasn't inside a traditional martial arts school. Okay. Now, obviously, you need to use common sense. You're an adult. You can decide if something feels right or not, if you don't want to go to somebody's house and train. But man, I'll tell you what, the best training I've gotten has not been in a traditional commercial martial arts school. It's been in somebody's garage, somebody's backyard, somebody's whatever, or in a park, okay? That's the truth of it all, okay? You're not going to hear this very often. This is not a popular idea or popular thought, but it's coming from me. After, you know, doing martial arts for as long as I have, I will tell you that some of the best training I've gotten was not in a commercial school, because commercial schools, they have their own things that they have to worry about. They're worried about marketing, keeping people in. They have to be careful about how hardcore their training is. There's a lot of factors when you run a martial arts school, okay? And so this is my honest truth about this is, so those are the different types of martial arts schools that you can just go, you can check out. Always do your due diligence. Check out who the instructor is and who their instructor was and what is their lineage, based on who they are, okay? That's very important. How long were they a student before they became an instructor? That is very important, okay? Nobody becomes an instructor after a weekend. You have to earn your stripes. You have to earn your way through to be able to be an effective fighter, technician, instructor, okay? You have to be able to do that. If somebody's only learned it for a week or even two years. There's people I know that I've heard of at least that were only study with a person for 2 years and then they're teaching what they learned. It's like, it's crazy, okay? It takes time to become an effective instructor. So with that being said, I hope this helps you to be able to decide. Go to somewhere that's the closest you can, okay? If it's far away, it's gonna be harder for you to be able to stick with it when something's far away. If you can go somewhere where it's really close by, walking distance even, that is the way to go. So with that being said, I hope you guys have a great day and thank you so much for checking out this video. I'll see you next time. Hey guys, thank you for checking out our video today. Comment down below if you have any questions about what we covered today. Go to our website, pinnaclecombatarts.com. There you can find out more about what I do and the classes that I provide. Thank you guys so much for your support and have a great day.